Welcome to the show. It's great to have your company right across Australia. First up this morning, fears of underworld retribution attacks in Melbourne after the assassination of a man with mafia connections outside his home.
Today's Chris Denahan joins us now with the details. Chris, good morning. Gangland violence has returned to Melbourne suburbs.
Yeah, that's right, Sarah. And police say that they are prepared for potential revenge attacks, and that is why they are treating this investigation as a high priority. John Latore, a fruiterer with links to powerful figures in the mafia, was gunned down outside his Greenvale home at 4:30 yesterday morning as he left for work. A woman inside the home heard the noise, came out and discovered the 64-year-old's body. Victoria police say John Latore was known to them.
I believe a family member heard what occurred outside and found the deceased in the driveway. They're quite distraught. They're not really in a position to provide too much detail at this point in time. Any incident such as this is quite concerning, and obviously Victoria Police will treat this as a high priority.
Latore, a former Liberal Party donor, ran a successful fruit and vegetable wholesaler's business based at the Melbourne market in Epping. As police hunt the attacker or attackers, Melbourne braces for potentially another underworld war. Sarah.
Yes, thank you.
Let's turn now to some news breaking on the Gold Coast overnight, where a house has gone up in flames at Tallai. Today, Queensland reporter Mia Glover joins us there live. Mia, good morning to you. One person has been taken to hospital.
Yeah, they certainly have. Carl, good morning to you. Well, they have been taken to Robina Hospital in a stable condition this morning. They were the only person inside this home at the time in Tallai when it all went up in flames just after midnight. You can see this morning that there is still parts of the home and the garage that are smouldering. We're seeing some ash drop from the roof still this morning. So, and the smell is still very much here in the air. Like I say, it was just after midnight that firefighters first received the call to this blaze. Initially, it was just the car on fire that they thought, but that quickly spread right throughout the house. The flames so severe that parts of the home have been completely destroyed. That person inside the home, like I mentioned, was rushed to hospital in a stable condition. Thankfully, he's doing okay this morning. Police say they're not going to be treating this as suspicious at this stage. That is because they're looking at maybe the fact that the owner had some candles burning in the house through the night. Fire investigators will be back here, though, a little later today, Carl.
Yeah, thank you.
Australian wine could soon rake in an extra $1 billion as it prepares to reclaim a large part of the Chinese market. China's Ministry of Commerce releasing a draft proposal to lift its crippling tariffs on our wine export after introducing taxes of up to 200% in 2021. A final decision is expected by the end of the month. A man is in hospital this morning after being stabbed in Melbourne's northwest overnight. The victim, in his 30s, was found with non-life-threatening injuries to his back at St Albans, although it's unclear what led to the attack. An elderly driver who hit a schoolboy on the Gold Coast has had his car stolen while stopping to help the 11-year-old boy. Police now on the hunt for the opportunistic thief who left the man deserted in Labrador just after 3 o'clock yesterday. The young boy is in a stable condition in hospital. Frustrated Commonwealth Bank customers were forced to wait several hours to access online services amid an outage overnight. Australia's largest lender posting a statement online acknowledging the impact on its NetBank web service and Commbank app at around 9:30 last night. Services were restored by 1:10 this morning.
Turning now to the Pentagon unveiling new plans that could see a major blow to Australia's hopes for US nuclear-powered submarines. US correspondent Jonathan Kersley has more. Jono, one key US congressman has already expressed concerns.
Yeah, Democrat Joe Courtney says the draft proposal put forward by the Navy, if it goes ahead, could have a profound impact on both the United States and Australia. What this draft proposal says from the Navy is that the US would build just one Virginia-class submarine over the course of the next year. Now, those are the submarines Australia is designated to get from about 2032, so that is still some time away. And the number one is a reduction from the planned two that the United States had last year. But in reality, Sarah, the the US shipbuilding pace had slowed dramatically. They were building just 1.2 submarines a year, significantly impacted by workflow shortages because of COVID-19. The Pentagon is denying that there is going to be any sort of real impact on the AUKUS alliance, essentially saying that there is significant investment coming in shipbuilding programs to try and shore up and quicken up the speed in which the United States can get these submarines out into the waters, not just here in the US, but eventually into Australia. 2032 is the first time Australia would get one. That would be a second-class submarine, a second-hand submarine. 2035 would be the second one. The first time Australia actually is due to get a fresh submarine straight off US production lines is not until 2038. Needless to say, though, still, this draft proposal from the Navy is causing some concern among key allies of the AUKUS agreement.
Yeah, that's for sure, Jono. Thank you.
Young criminals who film and post their offences to social media could be jailed for longer under a New South Wales crackdown. For more, let's bring in today's Sydney reporter, Jack Hahn in Mount Druitt. Jack, good morning to you. They could cop an extra 2 years behind bars.
Yeah, you're spot on, Carl. Good morning to you. And look, police here in Mount Druitt have pointed out the problem. It is that children will often get bail and then breach it by committing more offences, but soon that will become harder to do as the New South Wales government forces more magistrates to put kids behind bars, particularly once they commit their first breach of bail offence. And as you pointed out soon, posting and boasting about youth crime on social media could see youth criminals cop an extra 2 years behind bars. We've seen plenty of examples of where kids perhaps might steal a car and then live stream it on social media, but that will now attract heavy penalties. Youth crime has been hitting New South Wales hard, but it's the bush that is feeling most of it in the town of Dubbo over the last 5 years. Car thefts have soared by 15%, while in Moree, residents are living on edge. Relief coming for the town of Moree in particular, with an extra $13 million for police and for the courts. And while residents there are welcoming the announcement this morning, Aboriginal advocates argue that this will become an unmitigated disaster, Carl.
Jack, thank you.
A wild police chase through the New South Wales Central Coast has been filmed and posted to social media. A shirtless man eventually arrested after he was first seen crashing into a police car and then fleeing. It's understood he'd already assaulted an officer who had tried to arrest him earlier before leading police on the pursuit through Erina and hijacking another vehicle. Seven people are missing in floodwaters in Western Australia. Two four-wheel drives with children and adults inside left Kalgoorlie for the remote Aboriginal community Junjunjara on Sunday and hasn't been heard from since. A year's worth of rain has lashed the goldfields in just 3 days, with parts of the Kimberley also flooded, cutting off major road and rail links. A former New South Wales police officer is facing allegations he allowed his teenage son to fire a police-issued gun in May 2021. The 50-year-old slapped with four charges, including one count of possessing an unauthorised pistol. He faced a Grafton court yesterday afternoon and will reappear in May. A big blow to the state's force, with gun rules already under fire after Jesse Baird and Luke Davies were allegedly murdered by a senior constable using a police handgun.